The biggest concern we have is that existing environmental hazards, such as, for example, air pollution, noise, or extreme temperatures, they tend to affect the most vulnerable people much more than the general population. So what we see is that the people who are elderly, young children, those with existing health problems, or those on lower incomes tend to be much more affected by those hazards. We also see the differences in Europe between different regions, where some of the regions tend to be more affluent and enjoy better quality of the environment, whilst other regions might be more deprived and at the same time more polluted. In the EU, we have a really good policy basis tackling environmental quality, and many of the key pieces of legislation are actually including references to vulnerable groups. So, for example, the air quality directives or the environmental noise directive, the EU adaptation strategy, all of them are actually pointing out the importance of protecting vulnerable groups. We just need to put these policies into action. Well, if you want to be pessimistic, you can say that the climate is changing, so we can expect more extreme events in the future, that the European population is aging rather rapidly, and whilst the environmental quality is improving, it could be improving a bit faster. So if we don't take then action to improve the quality of life of the vulnerable people quickly, these environmental inequalities are likely to persist.